Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's opening week in the NFL, and today we have two teams who are more than ready to get the season underway. It's the Broncos going up against the Buccaneers. So now let's head on over to rainy Raymond James Stadium in Tampa to welcome in our announcing crew, Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis.
Larry, it's something that Floridians are all too familiar with as the rain continues to fall here at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. Today, it's the opener of a new NFL season between the Denver Broncos and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Set for football now on a rainy Sunday afternoon. And off we go from Tampa. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Deciding to take a timeout defensively. After the play on the ground, that brings watch up left, second down left, here. Then they're going to go soft on the corners. Winston to throw it this time. Trying to get it to Cobb, it's intercepted. A great read, it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. That is Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. It looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The starting 11 defensively for Tampa Bay.
Quan Alexander's one of the exciting linebackers in the league. His best forte? Speed.
Nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in the center of the top line? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
To his right. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked up. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there. Totally different factor. Just go out and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being.
And now the rookie's free. 30, 20. Roberto Aguayo now for the point after. And we'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward, but they kick it here, and it's good. The Bucs ready for the kickoff, and here we go. It's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And Denver getting set to take the field. And two interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing. Not quite at that level and not at that age. I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself. That was a fluke. And he went out there pretty well the rest of the day.
And he's got his man on the out route. The completion good for three, and it's second down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meeting with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, maybe.
Yeah, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on. Well, not that we had any questions, but it's obvious his arm does not hurt today, does it? He does not mind slinging it around.
He is firing that pigskin around the yard.
Yeah, took a deep downfield, taking shots. Unsuccessful there, but I like his moxie.
Here we go. Green.
They go play action now. Lynch. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw him out.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven.
No. Check. Patriots. Check. Patriots. 319. 319. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
They're going on fourth down. It's Lynch. Forced out to his left.
They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a two tight end set.
Let's go!
It's interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the two tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see two tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense was able to run successfully.
Partner, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
Ready, ready.
Now this time he'll look to throw. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physical. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Let's see what they go to here on third down and six. Yard line. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And Denver getting set to take the field. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, wants to see points on the board. So see if it changes a little bit from the same spot again.
Decision is here if they get to that spot.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might just start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time. And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
It's Lynch being chased out left. Now he'll let it go on the run. deep left side. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
What I loved about meeting with these coaches before the game is we didn't even have to ask any questions. They told us that they were going to be aggressive and push the ball downfield. They weren't successful on that play. We'll look for them to try it again later.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a push it. They're going to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
And not much of an opening there as he's only going to get this to about the 32. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
That was a really nice play. He'll be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a one-yard gain. He's going to walk one deep left side here. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had the fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete.
And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. Winston from the gun on third down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Oh boy, he fielded it right on the goal line. 34 yards on the return, but for a moment looked like he had a shot to go all the way. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They'll put two receivers here, two to the right. Now a play fake here on first down. It's caught inside the 25. And he gets this down deep into Tampa Bay territory. A nice job there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion.
He'll get six on the ground there, and it'll be second and goal coming up.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage, space up front, really well done.
They come out here in the yard. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Paxton Lynch keeping it himself on the quarterback sneak. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
for something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gotton. It's the Bucs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter, and they've got it here with a first down.
Tight, double tight. Ready,
after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack. Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about how to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. Nick says that we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
And that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
Together here from the D-line. And again, they'll go right back to their fullback. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. Yards still remaining here on third down. Second quarter. We'll be right back. They'll put two receivers left, two to the end. After the interception, here's Lynch. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? And Marvin right now just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is on to. At the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
He's going
to
look deep down the field. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And the offense in that middle ground here on third down. Third and five.
Here we go. Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Hurry up, give it all over! All right, now, lock it 56. Lock it. No. Check, Patriot. Patriot. Here we go. Green. All right, now, lock it 56. Lock it.
Lynch to throw again. He's going to go up top again. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful.
Well, Martin, I think the defensive fellas got the memo, and they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot, couldn't get it.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally someone said, let's try to put a stop to it and put people on it.
This is taken at about the 14. Motion the tight end across the formation.
Easy, easy, easy.
possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now a handoff looking right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage left defensively. Now Winston. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
But they went for the big play there. But that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. On second down, Winston again. To the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Intended receiver, and it's third down.
They come up in a two tight end look here.
Ready, ready, let's go.
And third down, Winston. Incomplete. The contact made the ball roll free and brings up third down.
Pretty reliable, usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And Denver getting set to take the field. Last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense up the board.
He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Branch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
See what his offense can do.
A little bit of momentum. Yeah, Every now and then you can actually tackle that guy.
10 yards still left on second down.
Let's go now.
They go play action. Winston. Looking for his running back, and he's got it. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
They get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. And he'll send the tight end in motion here. Play action now, Winston. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll be out of bounds past the 45. A good pick up there, 20 yards.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to swing the tight end free downfield for the completion.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. Play fake. Winston. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Jameis intercepted.